What is up, guys? It's time for Dylan, back at it again with another crypto video. What is up, guys? It's time for Dylan, back at it again with another electronics tutorial. In today's video, what I'm going to show you is how to combine the passive buzzer with the tilt ball switch. So in the last lesson, what we did was lesson number 8, where we talked all about the tilt ball switch. All we did was run the pre-built sketch that showed us how manipulating this tilt ball switch, we can turn on and off the LED that's located on our Elegoo Uno R3. So in today's video, what I did was I just combined that lesson with the lesson I just showed you before, which is how to make a song with the passive buzzer. So we did it in lesson 7. We talked all about the passive buzzer, how to make tones. And of course, I did a little lesson, which I'll go ahead and link right here if you guys are interested, where I showed you how to make Sea Shanty 2 from RuneScape Classic using a bunch of notes in our pitches.h file. So all we did was we just combined these two lessons. Of course, here, I will go ahead and show you what we have here. We have our passive buzzer, which is connected to the same exact pins, right? Pin number 8 is where we have our positive terminal for the passive buzzer. And then, of course, the other terminal is connected to our ground. And then we use the same exact wiring setup to connect our tilt ball switch. I want to make sure I keep it pointed down so it connects the circuit, which sends a high signal, which will send no tone to the buzzer. A little backwards, but this is how we have it set up. So once I tilt this up, what it's going to do is it's going to start playing Sea Shanty 2 from RuneScape Classic. Let's get it. And then once I have it tilted down, it will stop playing. So the way I have this set up, if you guys want to see the code, I literally just copied this exact same code that I built in our last lesson, and then I just incorporated it into lesson number 8. The only thing that I changed was, of course, the constant int. I changed it from the LED pin, which was pin 13. I changed it to pin number 8. And then, of course, when I incorporated this for loop, I put it in the else, and all I did was to change the hard coding of pin number 8 to buzzer. That's it. I also had to include both of these arrays that we built in that last lesson into our code here. Pretty cool, pretty simple. If you guys are interested, follow along. It's super easy to do. You guys can totally do this. Let me know what songs you guys are going to create. But of course, stay tuned, because in our next lesson, what we're going to do is talk all about servos. So I can't wait for this lesson. Make sure you guys stay tuned. Other than that, have a beautiful day, beautiful night, wherever you guys are. Dylan is out.